Hello everyone, myself Pawan Mukwan, Assistant Professor of EC Department at LG Institute of Engineering Technology. Welcome to the session of Radar and Navigation of ELC. In the last session we have started unit number 4, that is MTA and the Pulse Doppler Radar. Now the next topic is what are the limitations of MTA? The blank spots are the limitations of this MTA. That why? Because target will not be visible even it is moving. Because it is moving at the speed of blank spot. Okay. So this is the limitation because it is very dangerous in most of the cases. So how to overcome this limitation? First, if the blind speed is greater than a maximum radial velocity that is expected, then the product of wavelength and the pulse repetition frequency is to be large. Second, can also increase the wavelength and also increase the pulse repetition frequency. Alright. Third, we can use more than one PRF because we are going to operate it on more than one wavelength. Right. So what are the possible solutions? The long range MTI can be operated in the higher bands, higher microwave bands like L, S or any other higher bands, right? We know that there are different bands L, S, C, X, K, P and K, right? So if it is going to be operated at the higher band, higher frequency, then we can say that the effect of blind spot can be reduced. Second, if they are going to be operated with the blind speed and the ambiguous Doppler speed, we are able to estimate the accurate range information. Third, practically, if they are going to keep the first blind speed out of the expected range of the Doppler frequency, we are able to nullify the effect of blind spot. Okay, so these are the possible solutions to reduce the effect of blind spot. Okay, and the practical solution is we are going to use a multiple wavelength. Let me say we are going to operate at different or in the multiple frequencies. So that is known as the staggered PRF. Okay. So if we want a better clutter rejection, what we are going to do is we are going to use a delay canceller for the two types. Okay. First delay canceller, then it is going to delay and the original signal is going to be applied to the subtractor. Again, that signal is going to be applied with the canceller, and that signal is going to be delayed, and it is again applied to subtractor circuit. So finally, we are getting the output which has a better clutter rejection. Alright. So this is called the double cancellation. Now, response. What is the response of my MTA radar? Okay, at the output of full wave rectifier, we can say that the response is 4 sine square FD into T. This is the amplitude response, and this is the rectified waveform. Over here, rectified waveform is given as like it gives you only the positive spikes. Okay, we are getting only a unipolar waveform. So over here, the zero response occurs only when the target is moving at the blank speed. So the disadvantage is that a region of low sensitivity. Right? Apart from that, the ratio T1 by T2, if it is equal to 1, we can also lower the value of first blank speed, because the first null will be at FD is equals to 1 upon T1, that will become some more deeper, so it will become a trade-off. Alright? Now, what do you mean by pulse Doppler radar? Over here, the pulse radar, or we can say the technology of continuous wave radar. We can say we are able to add a mixture to the pulse radar. So the sample of transmitted and the received signal are going to be compared at the receiver. Alright? So the mixture output is a Doppler shift. So that Doppler signal is going to be shorted into the velocity categories, and that categories are going to be identified with the standard weather radar. Okay. Now I am going to focus on the pulse Doppler radar. It is used for a weapon fire control system. It uses only a single antenna. Okay, but it requires a high pulse repetition frequency, because we are going to transmit many pulses. High frequency is there, large bandwidth is there. We are able to get the large volume of range as well. Okay, and it will also give you the higher accuracy. Okay, but for this cycle, it is a more than 10%. Now, this is the block diagram of pulse Doppler radar. Right? Now in the pulse Doppler radar, we are able to identify that there is a transmitter and receiver, and for the transmitter and receiver we are going to use only a single antenna with the help of duplexer. Alright? So a transmitter is continuously going to transmit the signal of FP. Alright? With the help of this antenna. And after reflection from the target, the echo signal is going to be received at the receiver, and that signal with a reference signal from the transmitter is going to be applied to the mixture, and that signal after the up conversion or down conversion, it is going to be applied to the Doppler filter. Okay, and when the target is moving towards the radar or moving away from the radar, it is going to be displayed on the with the help of this display. You can use ASCOP or the PPA. Alright. Now what is general definition of this pulse Doppler radar? So radar that increase its PRF, which is high enough to avoid the problems of blank speed, it's called the pulse Doppler radar. So it may be acceptable to operate at a slightly lower PRF, because we need to accept both range and the Doppler amplitudes. So it is a medium PRF failure, pulse Doppler radar. Okay. So what are different amplitudes which can be possible? The first is the MTI with the low range amplitudes and many Doppler amplitudes. Second, the high PRF, that means a pulse Doppler radar with just the opposite. It may cause a many range amplitudes and no Doppler amplitudes. Okay, and if you want to use a medium PRF, that means a pulse Doppler radar with some of which. So, some pulse Doppler radar will use in medium PRF, another one will use the high PRF. Okay. So, what is the combination of it? So, the equipment which are different between the two are no longer significant enough to distinguish from one another. So, a pulse Doppler radar will receive a much more clutter than the empty reader. Correct? Apart from that, it requires a much improvement factor than does in the MTA. So what is the logical conclusion? The antenna side lobe clutter is large in high PRF, pulse Doppler radar, because there are many range ambiguities and which will cause the pulses simultaneously eliminating the clutter. Alright? Second, if the duty cycle is a 50%, then the antenna side lobes are simultaneously eliminating the half of the total clutter within the radar's coverage. Alright? What are the disadvantages? The larger side lobe clutter, which is viewed by a pulse Doppler radar, it is the reason why it requires a high improvement factor than the airborne MTA radar, which is having an equivalent performance. What are the specifics? Detect the aircraft target within the side lobe clutter, that means in the presence of clutter signal. It requires a bank of Doppler filters with its having a specific threshold value. Okay, for that our antenna must be operated or must have a lower side lobes. So what are the specific advantage? So the presence of this clutter free region is an important advantage of high PRF pulse Doppler radar, especially if we are going to detect the target which is having the high speed at the long range. Okay? So the what are the eclipsing loss? As the pulse Doppler radar cannot receive when it is transmitting a high duty cycle, which can result in a loss. So if the echo signal arrives when the pulse is going to be radiated, then the receiver is turned off. So my receiver is not going to receive echo signal at that time. So that is called the eclipsing loss.